Saving the Day. My text is the 17th verse of the 3rd chapter of Joshua, reading thus: And the priests that bear the ark of the covenant of the Lord stood firm on dry ground in the midst of the Jordan. And all the Israelites passed over on dry ground until all the people passed clean over Jordan. I am now to tell you of the salvation wrought in modern times in a river by a group of Negroes. The Mississippi River was hammering away at a given point in her levees. Behind the trembling embankment of earth, the people watched in an agony of fear. Their property and their lives were being menaced by the sea of angry waters that seemed to have chosen that spot for one last mad effort to break through and roll at liberty over the land teeming with life and pregnant with the coming harvest. Skilled engineers, with a previous history of the river before them, had spent the full force of their judgment in the construction of the levee, but, as the situation proved, had failed to give perfect security. The state and federal governments had exercised their full power in trying to meet the situation created, but the waters lashed and roared and laughed their best efforts to scorn. The citizens from the surrounding regions gathered in mass at the chief point of danger and were rushing sandbags to the front with all the speed at their command. In spite of all this, a break came, and with a gurgle of joy, the waters of the mighty Mississippi started through. In the twinkling of an eye, a band of Negroes offered their bodies as temporary sandbags. Wedging their frames into the break, they formed a human wall, and at the imminent peril of their lives, held the furious waters in leash until sandbags could be rushed to the break, and thus the day was saved.
Sitting in the corner to hear.